global pollution related to the production, transportation, and burning of fossil and nuclear fuels is destroying the world's ecological balance. CO2, SO2, and other pollutants caused by the burning of fossil fuels, such as oil, gas, and coal, are the primary causes of acid rain production and global warming. Here at the Technion, Israel's Institute of Technology for Teaching, Research, and Development, which is the Israeli equivalent to MIT, a select team of scientists headed by Professor Dan Zaslavsky, former chief scientist of the Israeli Ministry of Energy and former water commissioner for the State of Israel, has developed a revolutionary solution that will meet the world demands for future electrical power with a new, non-polluting energy resource. The solution, which can produce power on a massive scale, is called the Energy Towers. The idea for this new power source was first introduced in the early 1970s in a patent by Dr. Philip Carlson, a US physicist. Seeing the tremendous potential of this new idea, the Technion team worked many years developing the technology. The Energy Towers concept that emerged from the Technion research is to build a non-polluting power plant that produces electricity in large quantities and at a low price, utilizing virtually unlimited fuel, hot, dry air, and seawater. The Energy Towers concept is based on a very well-known physical principle in which hot air rises and cold air falls. To demonstrate this principle, we use a small tube and put dry ice at its top. In this model, the dry ice cools the air. The cold air descends and rotates a small propeller at the bottom of this tube. In the Energy Towers, seawater cools the hot, dry air, and the cold air falls and rotates turbines. The Energy Towers will be located in a hot, dry area near a large water source, such as an ocean or a sea. The seawater is delivered by pipes or canal to the operational reservoir, and then pumped to the top of the tower. There, the water is sprayed in small droplets by a spraying system into the hot, dry air, evaporating and cooling the air. As the air cools, it falls and gains high velocity. The wind speed can reach 50 miles or 80 kilometers per hour, rotating turbines located at the bottom of the tower and producing electricity. The brine residue is collected and stored in the brine reservoir, and from there it is conveyed by pipe back to the sea. 45% of the energy produced in this process is deliverable as electrical power. 33% is used for water pumping to the top of the tower, and the remaining 22% are energy losses. Such an energy tower can provide a city of around 1 million residents with all its electricity needs, which is equivalent to 460 megawatts average annual production. To achieve this energy production, the energy tower dimensions must be approximately 1,200 meters in height and 400 meters in diameter. The reason for building the energy tower plant so high is that the production of net deliverable power increases significantly as the tower height increases. In comparison to other non-polluting energy sources such as solar, geothermal, wind, and hydroelectric power, the energy tower is only slightly more expensive than hydroelectric power and far less costly than wind, geothermal, and solar power. In comparison to other polluting energy sources such as nuclear, coal, oil, and gas, the energy produced by the energy towers is not only renewable and clean, but also cheap. As the height of the tower increases, the electricity cost decreases significantly, and this is the reason for a tall structure. There are several major additional benefits to the project. Desalination of large quantities of seawater at approximately two-thirds the price that exists today. One energy tower can provide fresh, clean water to a city of 1 million residents. Inexpensive desalination will also create community, industrial, and desert agriculture development.
Energy towers that Professor Zaslavsky and his team are trying to develop is in fact the most promising way to convert on a large scale solar energy into electrical energy. And I believe if this project is going to prove itself economically, when it will be realized, we may be making a major contribution not only to the economy of the State of Israel, but to the welfare of the human beings all over.
The energy towers are a first, bold, and serious step of modern society to reverse the ecological damage caused to planet Earth from the exploitation of energy resources. Global energy needs will increase manifold during the 21st century. The energy towers, with its almost unlimited potential to create clean, renewable power, can participate in meeting these needs while protecting our planet.